Hey everyone, it's Rick. Welcome to the channel. I got the headphones in today, so hopefully you can hear everything better. Today I'm going to do something really quick, like impressionism. I'm just using basics acrylics, okay? I'll call out the colors as I put them up there. This is just ultramarine blue with, I lightened it up a bit with some white. Okay, so I'm going to do a quick, easy painting today. And I'm going to try and do it really loose. Everything's just going to be like swipes of the brush, okay, is what I'm going to try and do. But we need to get the sky up there, so I'm going to lighten up the bottom of the sky here just a bit. I'm just using the earth tones. All right, there's the sky. I'm going to make some water. But I want the water to be more grayer on the gray side. I kind of want this to just maybe be a little pond down here. Just a pond. Maybe we'll have a little land around it here. This small little pond. Trying to lighten up the back here. The mountain. I think I'm going to have like a hill coming in here like this first. Then maybe a hill coming in front of that one. So I'm going to make this one raw sienna. Raw sienna. I think I put a little bit of yellow in it. So we'll have a hill here. And I'm going to, put some trees up on top. But I'm not real loose trees. I'm going to actually brush them in. Just brush them down with hooker green with maybe some gray in it. Because those will be further back. This side of the hill, I'm going to darken it up a bit. Maybe we'll have it come in like this. Kind of give it some shape up there. This is it's a mixture of burnt umber, and I put a little bit of this color in with it to darken it up or lighten it up a bit. So we'll have that hill there. Let's for down here. I took a little red and added it into that raw sienna to get an orangey color. So let's make this land down here that color. I just put a little red in that raw sienna. That way we got three different tones going on. This is just the underpaint here. I'll put some of that red out on this side here. Alright, there's our... I'm going to let that dry. Let's do a quick mountain. I'm using a Filbert brush, by the way, just a number 12. there's not going to be any detail in this painting, so I'm going to mix a little Payne's gray and some white to get a mountain color. So I'm not trying to make my mountains perfect, so I'm just going to like wipe some color back there. I mean, I'm trying to make it come down on the sides, but let's just get loose with the brush back there. Bring that gray down into here. I'm going to lighten it up now with some light blue and white just at the bottom here. Have some cool mountains in the background there. All right, let's do some clouds. I'm just gonna stick with my big filbert brush, and basically I think I'm gonna have the clouds running up at at an angle, so I'm just gonna come in here and kind of start swiping up to the right. Okay, just throw some color in here. These are going to be clouds. Not too many, that's enough. I'm going to probably highlight it with a little bit of orange color when those dry a bit. I'm gonna take a little bit of light blue and white and come up in here and kind of put some indications of snow on these peaks here. Got a little blue in it, but it's going to soak in and turn gray. So let's take some blue now and very loosely swipe it down on the shadow side. Some light blue. If the white's already soaking in, go ahead and hit it again. I want it to have some white up there. All right, I think our underpaint's done. I kind of like that. I'm going to go to a smaller filbert brush now. A number, I think it's a 4. I want to put some trees on the top of this hill now. So I mixed, I mixed some Hooker Green and some black. But what I want to do is lighten it up a bit. So I'm going to put a little bit of white in it. Maybe a touch of gray. And it's going to be on this side here. So what I'm going to do is just kind of brush in. I'm going to brush in my trees. Okay. All the way down to this corner, the V shape here. That's it. There's my trees on that side. This side, I'm going to use the dark color now, okay? Hooker green with black in it. So let's run some trees down this side of the mountain cliff here, or hill. just like that. Maybe we can pull some of the color back just a little. I didn't pull any color back there. That's all right though. All right, there's our trees on that side. Around this pond, I want to put some bushes around the pond here. So I'm going to use this dark color. And what I'm going to do is start here and just go across my pond and I'll put in some bush tops here all the way across. Some bushes there. Let's put in a few bushes down here on top of the water. Just like that. Real loose. Just brush the color in. Now over here, I want to make some trees here. But I'm just going to kind of brush them in, okay? I'll make them like evergreen trees, but I don't want them to look like detailed, okay? So we're just going to make them look like trees by just brushing the color in, okay? Maybe some higher bushes over here. Just like that. All right, there's our trees on that side. That looks good. With some light blue, rinse your brush off. Rinse your brush off and grab some light blue color. And let's just come down on the right side of these trees, okay? Just to get some highlight in there. We can throw some highlights down in here if you want. Just like lights hitting them. It's gonna soak in, so let's throw some highlights out in here. Just like that, okay? Not too much. All right, now we're going to work on the reflection in the water. Rinse your brush off. Grab a little bit of that that dark color. And what we're going to do is put what's up there in the water. Okay? Just brush across some color there. And then for your trees, just run three trees down like this and then make like a large triangle shape. Just fill it in. Now rinse your brush off again and then wipe it off with a paper towel and let's come in here and pull that color. I mean, just wipe across what's in the water. Just go across it with a wet brush, just like that. That's going to be our reflection. Now I'm going to get a knife and I'm going to cut a water line across the back there now. Let's start over on this side. This is just a pond. We'll put a little water line on the reflection itself and just run some water out in here wherever you want, because it's not like a lake or something. It's just a little pond. You can put that white anywhere you want. Just make sure you keep your knife straight, okay?